Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to another session of social studies. Today we are on lesson number 6, our environment. Now, what is environment? Everything that's around us is our environment. We are surrounded by trees, we are surrounded by houses, we are surrounded by tables, we are surrounded by computers. So everything which surrounds us is our environment. It may be living things or non-living things. Now, look at Rama's neighborhood. Cross out the things that are making it dirty. It is very important that we need to keep our environment clean. If we are making our environment dirty, then we will be having problems, health problems, like water pollution. If we have, we will have health problems. Then air pollution also will lead us to health problems. Then noise pollution also will lead us to health problems. So that's why it is very important to keep our environment neat and clean. Now, whatever things are making Rama's neighborhood dirty, you have to give a cross mark. So let us see. Now, all the clothes are being scattered here and there. So this is making the environment dirty, isn't it? Now, these smokes are also making the environment dirty. Now, cutting down the trees also making the environment dirty. This water splash on the ground is also making the environment dirty. This garbage also, it is making the environment dirty, isn't it? So all these things are making our environment, Rama's environment, dirty. Next, what is environment? Our environment is made up of our surroundings. When we look around, we see living and non-living things. The living beings and non-living things make our environment. Plants, animals and humans are living beings. Air, water, land and buildings are a few examples of non-living things. Now, pollution. Pollution is an act of causing harm to our environment and making it dirty. Our environment gets polluted by some of our own activities. The most common types of pollution are air pollution, water pollution, land pollution, and noise pollution. Now, who is making this air, land, water polluted? We, the human beings. By cutting down the forest, we are making it by throwing the garbages, we are making the land polluted. By the smokes of the vehicles, then from the factories, it is making the air polluted. By burning the garbages also, it makes the air polluted. Then by throwing plastics on the water, it makes the water polluted. Then by simply honking the cars, it make a noise pollution. So we are the humans are responsible for making our environment polluted. Air pollution. Air pollution is an act of causing harm to the air. Some of the human activities that pollute air are smoke released from vehicles, smoke and dust coming out of factories, burning garbages in open spaces, blasting firecrackers. So all these things are making our air polluted. Land pollution. Land pollution is an act of causing harm to the land. Some practices that cause land pollution are felling of trees, overuse of pesticides in the soil by farmers, throwing garbage like cans, plastics and polythene bags in open spaces. So how we are polluting the land? By cutting down the trees. Then when the trees are falling into the land, by not cleaning the trees, the falling trees on the land, and then overuse of pesticides, chemicals on the soils, these are also polluting the land. Then throwing the garbage like the plastic items, then the cans, then also the polythene bags in the open spaces, all these are making our land looks very dirty, and this is the result why we are making we are polluting the land. Next is water pollution. Water pollution is an act of causing harm to the water bodies. Now, what are the water bodies? Water bodies are the ponds, the lakes, the rivers, the ocean, the seas. Some of the human activities that pollute water are throwing waste into rivers and other water bodies, releasing harmful waste from factories into rivers, washing clothes in rivers, bathing of animals and human beings in rivers. Now, throwing waste into rivers and other water bodies. Throwing waste means the polythene bags, then the unwanted garbages. When we throw into the water, it makes the water polluted. Then releasing harmful gas from the factories, the smokes which comes out from the factories and when they released into the water, this act also makes the water polluted. Then washing clothes in rivers. When we are washing clothes in the rivers, we are polluting the river. Then bathing of animals and human beings in rivers. We should not bathe animals and human beings also, because we don't know animals what kind of sicknesses they might be having, and human beings also we have different kinds of sicknesses. So all this gets mixed up in the water, and maybe like the people who takes the water from the river in order to plant the trees, in order to plant the crops. This may damage the crops in the farms, in the fields. So that's why we should not take bath in the rivers. Now, noise pollution. Noise pollution is an act of disturbing the environment with unpleasant and loud sounds. Some of the sounds that pollute the environment are loud music in factories, unnecessary honking of horns by people driving vehicles, loud music in vehicles and at public places, bursting firecrackers. So these are the things which makes noise pollution. Now there is an activity too. Look at the picture and answer the question. Are the surroundings clean? Yes or no? So look at the picture very carefully and ask the and answer the questions. Are the surrounding clean? Can you see the surrounding clean? No. If not, cross out the things that are making it dirty. Obviously, the surrounding is not clean. So now we have to cross out the things which are making it dirty. We can see all these things making it dirty, isn't it? All these things are making it dirty. So these are the things making it dirty. Next. Name the types of pollution you see here. I can see water pollution. Next, I can see land pollution. All the things are scattered in the land. Okay. Then I can also see air pollution. Next, saving our environment. It is very important to save our environment for the coming generation. If we are not saving our environment, if we are destroying the environment, then the upcoming generations, what will they have in future? Human activity is slowly destroying the environment. Therefore, it is our duty to protect and preserve it. When we keep our environment clean, we live a hygiene life. It is very important to keep our environment clean and hygiene. If we are making the environment better today, then it will be better tomorrow. Next, how can we save our environment? We should plant more trees. Trees make the air fresh and clean. We should not burst crackers. They release noise and harmful smoke in the air. We should use vehicles fitted with CNG kits instead of using petroleum. CNG means compressed natural gas. We should not use polythene bags and use only bags made of cloth and paper. We should always use garbage bins to throw garbage. Now, there are three R's: reduce, reuse and recycle. Reduce means to use less and not waste. Reuse means to use the things again and again for some other purposes. Recycle, to make something new out of waste. Now, reduce, to use less and not waste, means we can buy less things instead of buying more and more things. If we have a cloth with us, why to buy a new cloth if we can use them again and again? Now, reuse, if our clothes get faded, we can use it for other purposes. We can use it for cleaning purpose. We can use it for covering our TVs or some other things. Next, recycle, to make something new out of waste. If we are having a cup which has become bad, only one part of the cup, a coffee cup, has become bad, so at least we can utilize a cup. We can make something out of the cup. We can plant some trees, we can plant some saplings in the cup. This means we can recycle it. Now, filling the blanks. Smoke coming out of vehicle causes dash pollution. What does it cause? It causes air pollution. Throwing waste into river causes dash pollution, water pollution. Firecrackers causes dash and dash pollution. Firecracker causes noise and also air pollution. Dash beings and dash things make our environment. Dash beings means human beings. Not human beings, but we can say it as living beings. And non-living things. Next, dash is an act of causing harm to our environment. What is that act? Pollution. Next, we have choose the correct answer. What makes our environment? Options are land, water, air, all of this. So all of this makes our environment. Vehicles should be powered by dash, CNG, petroleum, CGG and CG. So we saw here that we should use vehicles fitted with CNG. CNG means compressed natural gas, instead of using petroleum. So the answer will be CNG. Trees make the air dash, dirty, impure, fresh, unclean, fresh. A clean environment means dash, hygienic, unhygienic, unhappy, sad, hygienic. We can save our environment by dash. Planting trees, cutting trees, wasting water, brushing crackers by planting trees. Match the following. Environment. Environment means what is surrounding. Pollution. Pollution means harmful activities damaging environment. Water pollution. Water pollution means washing clothes in river. Air pollution means smokes coming out of the factories. CNG, compressed natural gas. Now, this was about the chapter, our environment. You should keep in mind how to save our environment and what are the things we shouldn't do which makes our environment unhygienic. So I hope so you have understood the chapter. Next time we will meet with the next new chapter. Till then, take care, students, and thank you so much.